We've sunk an enemy destroyer.
In the waves she lurks, the ocean's stealthy queen, with torpedoes armed, her silent storms are seen. In the deep she hides, her czar is in sight, a ghost in the seas, a phantom in the fight. Ruler of the deep, silent and profound, in the art of war where her foes are bound. She strikes with grace, a force unseen, in the world of warships, she is the queen.
Hey team, this is Ripper here. You guys are doing fantastic today. Got a really fun and interesting discussion video about the map Hotspot, and it's one of the most frustrating maps to play against, but actually this strategy is seemingly working pretty interestingly well, and I just want to talk about it and have a discussion and see what you think. Before we get in, like, subscribe, bell button, I appreciate all the supporters of the channel. Can't thank you guys enough for all that you guys do, and look forward to some great times, and I look forward to giving another premium giveaway at 4,000 subs. And as always, having a blast talking about sailing ships, shooting ships, and learning something and having a blast at the same time. So let's get right to it. All right, so here we go. Continuing the video, we're talking about the map Hotspot. And why is this map so interesting and frustrating sometimes at the same time? It's fun because there's all this island cover. It's fun to cap and, you know, contest the cap and get those close-in engagements. And of course, you got Alpha Bravo over here that are kind of gimme caps, in my personal opinion, and it opens up options of flanking the enemy, right, in these positions. So what do normally players do? And I've seen all the strategy is they send one destroyer player right down to cap at this spot, and of course we in turn send one right there, and they hide behind these little islands, and there's no line of sight between them, and it's really just a contesting spot at that point, and it really renders the destroyer useless, and their guns aren't able to be used, their torpedoes really are not all that effective, and it's really two players are literally just their whole goal is to sit there. And I've heard many teams ranging from Gale all the way to Hurricane Typhoon players say this is the best strategy right now, because it's not necessarily bad, but you're stopping the points from ticking up because, why, you're not contesting the map. Meanwhile, you have one destroyer going to Alpha, and you have the other one, yeah, and Bravo. So you get it. You got these two caps, and now you're figuring out, how do I overwhelm Charlie to figure out how to solve this problem? So what do most teams do? I've seen many teams just kind of do this simple, have a cruiser park here, battleship go there, maybe battleship lingers in the background to shoot. Of course, you have another flanking cruiser this way, and that's pretty much the game right there. And it's really just figuring out flanks. I've seen other enemy teams try to do a heavy push through the eastern side down the 8, 9, 10 line to overwhelm the enemy, and hopefully they get a shot into this destroyer right there. I've seen that strategy. I've even seen other teams really just hold Charlie and really do this like fast cruiser builds and going down that flank and really trying to contest while they're just kind of holding right here just to stop any kind of aggressive push. So that's what I've seen from the north, from the south. It's essentially the same thing. You know, people just post up here, two cruisers there, and they may, you know, do a wide flank push. Going down this way is really, really long on the western side, unless you have a really, really fast destroyer or cruiser. And really just everybody just lingering in the back right here. And it's really a stalemate at this point. It seems kind of boring and uninteresting. So my thought was, we're non-traditional here at my channel. I always try to think outside the box, figure out different systems, and just having a blast and sharing ideas. And that's the best way you can learn and overcome that. And I think that's one of the good things. So for this particular strategy, what we did, and I have both videos coming from the north and the south. So for this instance, coming from the south, we have initially literally an overwhelming push where I basically tell the players what we're going to do right here is we are going to overwhelm the cap and everybody get a position. Like one person take a lane through the western side here and grab an island. The goal is to overwhelm this destroyer from the left flank. You're going to have the normal destroyer push through the middle here and use either radar or hydro and really overwhelm this particular destroyer here, causing them to freak out and make a mistake. And that's the key, the name of the game. You want the destroyer player or player to freak out and cause and make a mistake. And then you have another cruiser coming up this side to hold that flank. The battleship will go in tow and follow up through the gaps right there. And this is essentially what you're looking at. And the idea, instead of telling people what to do, I give them an objective. Because people are smart enough to know what to do with their ship and how to play it. And I cannot micromanage it. Again, I'm in the military. We teach people not to micromanage everything. You trust your people to make the best decision possible, because you can't be everywhere at once. And you're going to have to, you know, stop you know, being more of a dictator and being an empowerer. So you want to empower your people really to say, hey, you figure out what your ship can do and how can you overwhelm this capper here and just freak out the enemy. And it turns out to be very, very effective. And really, here's the cool thing. You have these islands right here to block and shield you from incoming fire. And now here's the problem for the enemy team. Once we've eliminated this player right here, you see, you eliminate the player right there. Look what you have open for you. Now you have a fortress. Now that you have a fortress, look what the enemy team has to do. Whoops, I don't want to delete that. The enemy team now has to figure out how to break through this particular cap from these positions. I mean, what do you do at this point? You know, now that we've engulfed Charlie and we've taken Bravo, we have a 2-cap advantage. Now, it really is determined on how strong your destroyer player is over here to take on a 1-on-1, maybe even 2-on-1 situation where, honestly, you just got to kite away and fend off this opposing force. And if they do swing around the flanks here, I'll show you that. If they do intend to swing them this way, then all you got to do is just push up and cap from Alpha and do the, you know, merry-go-round. And that sent you still have the 2 caps right there. So I've seen this turn out very, very well. We'll take a look at it in both videos. And you're going to see, like, what does the enemy team have to do in order to overcome this fortress? They have to either push through a gap right here, which means they are focus fired in. If they try to take off from north, obviously they'll get pinpointed down. If they try to come back through this gap right here, they're going to get focus fire down. See, look, you're defending all three entrances to this fortress right here, that I call. And it is a really frustrating thing to do. And I like to see other teams try to overcome it. But when we did this, it really worked very well. So let's take a look at the replay in the videos and see how it goes. All right, we are on the map hotspot here with the overall push of Overwhelmed Charlie Cap, and let's see actually how it works. We're playing the Khabarovsk here, and the Khabarovsk is probably one of the most tankiest destroyers ever played, and I think going solo is pretty darn easy. Look at that right off the bat, and now I'll focus more on the gameplay at Charlie. I'll get a free mouse here so I can take a look, and just let's see how it actually turns out, and forgive me, I'm not really familiar how to move the camera around while we're doing the replay here, but let's see if we can see the Khabarovsk right there. He's going to get focus fire right there off the bat. Look at that right there. He is literally just overwhelming the power, and he's freaking out now because now he has to figure out an escape route, because now that he has to figure out a course of action to get out, but he's being overwhelmed by the San Martin, the Smallen, being radar, whatever that means, spotted, and he goes down. There's the first kill. Now we have a Daring. Now, Daring right there has the problem of how do I get out of this situation? Because now I'm not realizing that I'm being overwhelmed by 1, 2, 3 radar ships, Smallen, Des Moines, and San Martin, and I have no backup because Kleber is dead. Saint Martin's out of position. See, look, there's no way he can really bring his guns to bear on the enemy force. He can raid all he wants, but now he's being overwhelmed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ships that Daring has to fend off. Puerto Rico and the destroyer over at Alpha. Montana is firing, but he's firing into nose-in ships here, and there's too many. He's got to figure out, well, what do I do? Who do I focus on? And then we got Wisconsin in the back here. He's got an island blockage, so it's really going to be very, very difficult. You know, meanwhile, we're shooting at the Puerto Rico. Again, we're being that distracting player because now we're taking 2 guns out of their side. Now the Daring has to figure out, how do I survive this onslaught? He's got a reverse. He's caught by the Des Moines. He goes forward. He's caught by St. Martin. And then he's caught by the Smallen if he does push forward. And at this point, yeah, it's pretty much, I've got nowhere to go. I'm overwhelmed. It's almost like task saturated, where I've got too many things going on. And this is how you overwhelm the enemy. Shock and awe, really just confusing and figure out. And he goes down. He can't really figure out what course of action he can do to get out of this situation. And now we've got the other destroyer, the last one. We've taken out 2 destroyers, a 3 destroyer versus 2 front here. And now we're going to go ahead and take on the Daring. Now, I can't win this battle here with the Puerto Rico and Daring shooting at me. I have to get out of dodge, and I've damaged on, and I've got this super heal that is really, really makes the Khabarovsk really like a zombie ship. And I'm going to really just kind of fade away and just kind of hold back and figure out the course of the situation, analyze it first, and then we'll figure out what's the best thing to do. Meanwhile, the Wisconsin and Montana are getting shot at by a massive front, and they really don't know how they're going to push this single-handedly. I mean, how are you going to push, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ships inside of guarding Charlie, that fortress of solitude there, trying to get get points, and the enemy team has to figure out, how are we going to push this literally defensive position with only about 2 or 3 ships here, and it's going to be very difficult. Meanwhile, Khabarovsk is going to hold Bravo Cap, which is going to be very difficult to push as well. Daring pushing into a Khabarovsk is going to be very, very struggly, be a struggle and difficult. And then we're going to call in our Smallen. He's not really needed much at Charlie, and he can go in and hunt on the Daring. Meanwhile, we got Radar and the Smallin with Radar also coming over to support. And that'll turn out to be a good supporting role. We call in for backup. Never ever try to figure out, hey, I can do this on my own. There's nothing wrong with being a team player, coming in, helping your team out. There we're going to shoot the Daring, start a couple fires on them. Meanwhile, Montana and Wisconsin enemy team over there is trying to figure out how to push into this fortress. And we're going to go ahead and continuously fire on the Daring. Yeah, it's proving to be a little bit difficult right here. And yeah, he goes into smoke, so hopefully me and the Smallin can take him on. Meanwhile, we can shoot out of Montana and start as many fires as we can. We're going to keep firing. Smoke, yep, okay. There we go. Let's see if we can take the Daring. Hopefully he pushes into us head on. No, actually, we have... Ooh, it's okay. Enemy team is now the San Martin over here, and Wisconsin trying to flank in. And again, see the problem they're facing. They got to push into a tunnel, the fatal funnel of death here at the gap. Meanwhile, they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ships literally shooting at that gap. It's going to be very difficult. And then also, we have us shooting the Puerto Rico, so it takes their guns out as well because the Puerto Rico will be focused on me or the Smallin. And the Daring is also focused on as well. So again, they don't have any backup. And that's the thing you could do is divide and conquer, like they've always said. You know, a divided nation shall fall, and with cannot stand. And really, if you divide their forces up to this point where their focus fire becomes ineffective, then that's the strongest point you can do and make for an enemy team. And really here, all the Daring can do is smoke up and run for cover. And that's why we're just being a harassing destroyer and just holding off their advance as much as we can and keeping them separated and divided. Notice the enemy team is not in a position really to just regroup, reassess, and to get their firepower on. Now we've got the Des Moines, got the Daring being radared around. We're going to take advantage of this. Ooh, he's almost dead right there. We're going to see if we can start as much fire or as many fires or even get just enough damage. He gets a great acceleration right there. And that was me. Oh, this is my bad. I did not see those torpedoes, but you know what? We got to take this Daring down before we go down. So let me see if I can get a couple shots off before I get hit, and boom, I'm down. Way to go, Kelly Fish or Kefa right there. I can't see your name. Sorry. Yeah, taking us down with the torpedoes. And now all we have left is five ships to three. We could still lose this. The Wisconsin goes down to the Des Moines. That's just being burned down. And of course, they lost their Montana as well from focus fire. And really, it's just mopping up the game at this point, just taking on the Puerto Rico. And it's just, they just can't do really much at this point. Yeah, and yeah, he's just going to get focus fired from both ends. And it's a fortress, I'm telling you. And Daring cannot push in by himself. One lowly destroyer, low health, 1, 2, 3, 4 ships. Yeah, it's going to be really, really difficult at this point. He's just going to get focus fired down and blap, and that's how you win the game. So that's how that actually played out from the south. Now let's take a look at a video and check it out from the north. All right, again, this is Hotspot from the north, and this time we're in the Lushun, another powerful kind of destroyer, but just as kind of a zombie destroyer where it's really just hard to kill and very powerful guns. So right now, right off the bat, and again, I'll move the mouse so you can look around here, free look. Notice that the Daring in there is also in that little position where he's hiding, and just being, look at that. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ships coming in and literally cutting off his escape from the left, cutting off his escape from the right. All he can really do is just kind of run away, and then he's exposing himself to shots from the center, the left, and the right, and he's being radared. So there's really nothing he could have done right there, and that's just overwhelming the cap, freaking out the player, causing them to make a drastic move and make a mistake, and they just were not ready for it. Again, I like that shock and awe and surprise. It really gets the enemy caught off guard, and pretty fun. So you guys can try it out if you want to take a look at the video and see how it goes. Meanwhile, in the Lushun, we're going to take on two destroyers, on Marceau and maybe the other, what is it, Daring? Or Daring, yeah, it was another Daring. So, man, I cannot believe how powerful the Lucians is right in this regard. I would think a Marceau would melt it very, very well, and I have been melted down by Marceaus before, but man, something about the Lucians, you start off with AP. The AP is very, very powerful, so it really negates the damage from the Marceau, you know, that French saturation, because if you're using AP, it doesn't really matter. It's just going to go boom right through and get maximum damage. Now, if he's angled in like this, I'll switch to HE, so you're going to see me switch back and forth, which is not really bad in Lucian, because the reload time is 1.3 seconds. So if you take a look at that, that's how a good destroyer player can switch back and forth and use the appropriate shell for the appropriate moment. So like right here, he's nosing in. I'm just going to use, you know, HE and just look, I'm not taking too much damage. You know, once that French saturation kicks in, so you notice it's going to kick down back to lower health. So we're taking all the damage we can off his ship, 924. Now we got that zombie heal going, so we're slowly healing as he's trying to take damage off him. It's really annoying playing against the Lucian right here. And look, we're just taking 462, pretty much saturated at this point. So we're not getting the full damage like we used to, but you know what? 462 over time does melt. It's like death by 1,000 paper cuts, and it eventually will wither him down. And he's only using the front two turrets because he's angling in. Since he's angling in, he can only get two turrets on us, which cuts his DPM in half, and boom, he goes down. We switch targets to Daring, And it's the same situation. Now we're just going to, now he doesn't have French saturation, so I know I can just melt this guy using either AP or HE from distance. I like AP or HE so I can know, I can guarantee damage and be consistent, because if he noses in like this situation right here, I'm not wasting time switching shells, and I'm just trying to start a fire, and he's going to go into smoke. So let's see if we can start a fire and get anything going, or even get a reset right there. Somebody's spotting me, so I got to go undetected. So that's a good decision right here, is to go undetected right now. I'm going to push him in the smoke when I got the 5 kilometer hydro. So another good thing about the Lushun is the 5.5 kilometer hydro, which detects everything, of course, as you already know, inside of smoke. And if nobody's spotting for him, he's literally caught inside of his smoke, and he's just a sitting duck at that point. And that's our strategy right there. That's what we want to do. I've analyzed the situation. I look at the area. Nobody's around to help him out. No backup, no radar outside the Puerto Rico's too far away. So I notice, hey, I'm going to go into his smoke and take him head on, because I know I can win this battle. So again, you got to analyze that situation right there. Can I win this battle? Can I win this duel with the tools I have and the ship I have available to me? My RPF is locating that he is straight ahead of me right there, so I know where he's at, and now I just got to really just continuously push straight into him, and there he is right there. We spot him with our detection. It's pretty good. And of course, we then shoot AP into a side. Look at the AP is doing some great damage in the side. I love the AP on the Lushun. It's very, very powerful. And we've got the RPF located, and our hydro is detecting his torpedoes, which we know we can dodge. And now here's another downside for him. He is perma spotted by me, my hydro, because my hydro is 5.5. So I'm driving towards him. He's trying to drive away. He can't get outside of that range. There's a mountain in the middle of us right here that is blocking his line of shot to me. Therefore, I can just maneuver undetected. And I'm not detected right now. He has no idea where I'm at. I've got RPF. Now, he may have RPF as well. He has a general idea, but he can't see line of sight to me. He doesn't know what I'm doing. And I'm just going to round the corner and continue to spot while other people are shooting at me. He's distracted. And here we're going to just bury AP into his broadside right here. Let's see how the AP works on him right here. Yep, very good damage, right? We're getting some nice AP damage. Now that he's gone, okay. I'll show you that this is that position right here. When he goes past this 45 to 60 degree, how do I know that? Again, I've been teaching guys, up and down is 12 o'clock, right? This is to your, if you had a clock right now, this is 12, 11, 10, 9. If he goes to this 10 to 11 o'clock range, that's when you start switching to HE, because then any AP hitting at this angle is going to just get deflected, bounce right off. That's what AP shells do. And they hit angled armor, they bounce right off, doing no damage. At this point, HE is your best bet. It causes less damage, but it's guaranteed damage, because it doesn't matter what angle you do. Any HE damage hits them, it's going to be devastating. So again, up and down from 10 to 12 o'clock right here, that's about 45 and greater degrees. I'm going to switch to HE. Anything from 10 o'clock, 9, I'm sorry, 12, 11, 10, 9 o'clock, 10 to 9 o'clock, this is that 45 or less degree breakage right here. Once I get to 45 degrees or less to me perpendicular, that's when I start using AP. It will pummel him even more. So let's take a look. There, see that deflections right there? A lot of those deflections. So we're going to switch to HE right there and just get that more and more consistent damage. And it's just so devastating to him. I mean, he just gets blasted by the St. Martin right there. Way to go right there. And now it's pretty much, look what happened to the cap. We overwhelmed it. We closed all the gaps, and all they have left is the two battleships in the back, and that's game over for them. So we'll just speed it up and let you see how it unfolds. Yep, battleship, yeah, there's nothing more they can do. They just get shot at and blasted, and yeah, at this point, it's just free damage. Wisconsin takes out the Montana. We get all this. Look at the damage. I love the Lushuns for this reason. And yeah, it's 231, but man, over time with a rate of fire, and we get torpedo damage as well. This thing is a beast. So let's take a look at the overall replays and see actually how they turned out, so you can get a bird's eye view of what I was talking about, of the overwhelming the cap and building a fortress around Charlie Cap. All right, so let's take a look at the replay overview of this map right here. Hotspot, and as you can see, again, initially we got Smallen entering and taking on the Kleber head-on right there. So there's the cool thing, a head-on, you know, kind of engagement collision, and very powerful, very ballsy on the Kleber, just go straight in like that. And then this is how we overwhelm. The Des Moines radar there, Smallen radar, and we have a St. Martin radar. Three radars in the cap, very, very good. And you got to obviously manipulate it, coordinate it, so you have one radar going off at a time rather than all of them at once. So we have Kleber getting shot up. Look, there's nowhere he can go, but he has the only extra strategy is to leave the cap. And right at that point, he's got three ships focus firing on him. He goes down. Khabarovsk, we already talked about, takes Bravo. Now here's where we overwhelm Daring. Daring is being overwhelmed from the right, from the left, and through the center. All he can do is go back and then forward. He's dead right there. And that has how the cap is now overwhelmed. Now look what kind. Look at the firing angles that the Wisconsin, Montana have. Really not much there with these islands in place protecting from broadsides, and is really just devastating. Look at that overwhelming firepower on the Wisconsin. There's really nothing he can do. It just gets blapped and just melted down. Of course, the Alpha Cap is getting also shot from here. That's giving us position. So we have battleships that are moving up front for base of fire, and really we got the small end of Khabarovsk coming back over. Wisconsin is now just kiting away and just getting blapped. Any kind of, I guess you could say, what position they have to do to get their guns on the bear, when they get in any position where they can fire, they're spotted immediately, and then they're just overwhelming focus fire, which is the name of the game right there. Montana goes down, and then of course we have focus fire on Wisconsin, and then yep, he goes down, and all that's left is these three ships right here. I take that torpedo hit and Puerto Rico's focus fire down, and then we win the game on points taking out the daring. So that was that. You could see how just this little position right here is so, so powerful of just building a defensive position and a bunker, if you will, at Charlie. So let's take a look at the other from the north now and see how that actually turns out and works. Okay, so this is hotspot from the north again. This time in the Lushuns, like we showed earlier. Now, Smallin races right into the bat, right into the cap, right off the bat, and just tries to take this island right here and hold. Meanwhile, we have 1, 2, 3. Look at that. Oh my goodness. We have 4 radar cruisers. Not a very fun match for destroyer at all. Notice again, the daring just has nowhere to go. Even the smoke doesn't do anything for him. I mean, all he can do, he can't reverse. And then if he goes reverse, he's slowing himself down. He's going to get flanked from the small one from the left, and then the Brisbane and Des Moines on the right. All he can do is go forward. And it's just too much overwhelming firepower. This point, the battleships are too far in the back to be kind of any kind of effect. Again, this is just, now this is dependent upon your destroyer player out. Alpha, you have to pick your strongest ship right there in order to hold off 2 destroyer advances. And it's just, like I said, overwhelming. Mosfa can only go into this little gap right here. Puerto Rico can't really have any other options. Hiding behind islands not really going to do anything for you. And again, we have the Schlieffen rounding the corner and just obliterating everybody right there. Daring is probably going to go down right there. And now it's just that one-on-one or two-on-one, or sorry, two versus the whole team. And the battleships are just in the back. And again, this is another bad thing too. If you're in the back and you're behind islands, you're not able to bring your weapon systems to bear. Not to say that's the fault of anyone. It's just the nature of the game these days, and it's really just the way positioning just worked in our favor. Again, this is exactly why this position right here is so powerful and pretty overwhelming. You can have people literally post up on these openings, and everybody's calling focus fire on the gaps, and you're really just holding a room and say, hey, hold the front, hold the windows, hold the doors, and anybody coming in, you just blast them. So that's how that worked out. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think in the comments below. As always, thank you for your support. Like, subscribe, all button below, and as always, in the next 4,000 subs, doing a premium giveaway, and I can't thank you guys enough for supporting the channel and making this place a great place to have great conversations, making good friends, and building a better community and having fun at the same time. So as always, you guys stay safe, and we'll see you guys soon. Take care. Cheers.